Light of day and headlining Bob's birthday bash, the Smithereens, as their year-long 30th anniversary celebration of the multi-platinum major label debut, especially for you. And we got Pat DiNizio on the phone. How you doing, pal? Pat, you there? Hold on, let me try again. There you go. Hey, Pat.
Hey, hi, guys.
Here you are.
Is Vinny there?
I'm right here.
That's my man.
What are you doing? How are you feeling?
I'm good. I made some gravy for my mom. She fell and hurt herself, so I made her, you know, some ziti with meat sauce. You know, Vinny, you know what I'm talking about.
You're a good guy.
You got to get the ragu cooking.
You know, we hit a certain age now, and we become the caregivers, right?
Yeah, you got to do it.
Now, wait a minute. How do you make the gravy? You make the gravy from scratch?
We got to cook the onion and the olive oil. Good.
That's
good
right.
Stuff, right. Right. So, you cook the onion first, then you throw in your garlic.
Right.
I buy this really, the best brand of canned crushed kitchen-ready tomatoes are called Pastene, P-A-S-T-E-N-E.
Okay.
You put those in, you cook it a little while. You can either bake the meat or you can fry it. Today I fried it, and you get this, you get some beef.
Right.
Get a big piece of pork that you quarter off the bone.
There you go.
Meatballs, sausage. My mom likes pepperoni.
In the gravy.
In the gravy, yeah.
How about that?
And so, but I cook it for like 5 hours.
I don't think I can go home and find any of that.
That's the best thing.
Whoa.
Like, you know, Sunday morning, then you watch the football game and you're all set for halftime, right? How about that? So, Pat, do you believe it's been 30 years since it all began, right?
Well, it's actually 36 years, yeah, but 30 years since the first album came out. But it's funny, when you finally get your foot in the door of a career, you get a break and you don't believe it's actually happening to you, but we were around for 6 years. Mm-hmm. Then he probably saw us play at the Stone Pony,
yeah,
hanging out with Lance and those guys.
Oh, sure.
Wandered in, you know, in the old days. But, the public at large, if they see you on MTV, if you're lucky enough to get on MTV in the first place back in the 80s, and we were no one's idea of what a rock band should look like. They were, you know, big hair bands, you know.
Yeah, you were the alternative. You know, and I remember, you know, when you came out, and you guys did the entire Meet the Beatles album. What made you do that? What was that like? How much fun did you have doing that?
I was sitting in the doctor's office, or the dentist's office, and there was a magazine called the American Heritage or something like that, and it said 1964. Of course, you remember 64, Vinny, right?
And
yep. 1964, the year everything changed. It was about the Vietnam War. It was about the aftermath of the Kennedy assassination. It was about
Lyndon Johnson taking over. I remember that. CNN, right?
Society. It was about the civil rights movement. But it was really, this magazine was about Beatlemania and the release on December 26th of 63 of I Want to Hold Your Hand on Capitol Records, and then subsequently the February release of Meet the Beatles. And I mean, I was young, but all I can tell you is there was a garage band on every corner in every small town in New Jersey and, mm-hmm, and in America within weeks. I think you can verify that, Vinny, right?
Well, I was 14, and I was in a band.
You and me both were probably playing before the Beatles came out. I know I was.
Well, I played with Sonny Ken.
Yeah.
You know, and but we actually did some Beatles songs when they came out. Yeah. We tried anyway.
So anyway, I was looking for a way to reintroduce the Smithereens to all those nice people who had given us a career and bought the records and had sort of taken themselves out of the game in the sense that they weren't an active audience anymore, not going to as many concerts, not really buying as many records. They got jobs and mortgages and children.
Mm-hmm.
And I called the head of the record label. I said, I've got an offer you can't refuse. And he said, what is it? I said, the Smithereens versus the Beatles. And he said, I love it. So, you know, within 10 seconds. And it became a surprise hit for us. It put us in the arts and leisure section of the New York Times and relaunched another phase of our career. And, you know, it's given us a lot of time as a result. And people really liked it. We heard back from Paul, Beatle Paul, and we heard back from George Harrison.
How about that?
Yeah, that's cool.
And they enjoyed it. And, you know, we didn't know it at the time, of course, Vinny, but there were no Beatles records available to the, you know, Beatles starving for iTunes downloads fans.
No, there was none of that going on.
They bought our record. because they couldn't buy the Beatles.
That's good stuff.
Anyway.
We tried to sell them is what we were trying to do.
Yeah.
You want to buy a record? You know, that was us.
And now you're going to do it especially for you. Are you doing that in its entirety as well, right?
Yeah, we are from beginning to end, starting, I guess, coming up. I mean, they say we're doing it this weekend. I mean,
yeah.
We're prepared for it. I'm not certain. But we actually commissioned a friend of ours who's a very good filmmaker who worked with me on my ESPN baseball rock and roll special that Bruce was actually in a couple of years ago, Seventh Inning Stretch, and helped me put together the films for my Vegas show that I did at the Riviera for a year back in 2012, Confessions of a Rockstar. He made a 45-minute film that runs the length of the entire show.
Oh, man.
And it takes you back to 1986.
That's going to be great. Pat, thanks so much for coming on. Real fast, I got to hit the traffic in 10 seconds. If you could see any album live, performed on stage, what album would you like to see?
The first Black Sabbath album.
Woo! Hey, look at this.
Yeah.
It's all jamming.
All right. You got it.
I may see it because I'm going to see him February 25th, the last tour.
I want to see some of your album.
I'm taking my daughter, my 21-year-old daughter, for her birthday. Thanks, guys.
Got it.
See you Saturday, right?
I want to see you do your album is what I want to see.
You're a good man.
Got it. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye, guys.
Got
see
it.
Ya.
Pat DiNizio from the Smithereens.